to look human, you're going to the farm. It's as simple as that.
Do you have any idea how much it costs to have an entire family in Glamour?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
Crane must have taken a shard with him. The open arms.
Enjoy your stay.
If you had just waited for me to explain before telling Beast.
Bigby, how could you do this to me?
I guess I finally see you for who you are! Tell me who did it! Just tell me who did it! I know you know!
I don't think he did it.
What?
Look at him. Do you really think this man murdered these women?
But, you know...
Just take him, okay? Take Crane.
Well, this is gonna be a beautiful relationship we have with you guys. Really, I mean it.
Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the Queen.
I think that's it. Holy jamoly, I remember we did so much. How long has it been? Look, I have no longer but at least I'm back to normal and
business. The silver slug deformed and shredded on impact.
He'll be okay, though. He'll be okay?
His internal organs are positively riddled. If I don't extract every single scrap of silver, he's liable to suffer some long-term toxicosis. Easy there. Try not to move.
Jeez.
We can't keep meeting this way, old boy. I figured I'd be done before you were conscious. But there's little I can do for the pain.
Swineheart, how bad is it?
Well, not the worst I've seen, but damn near it. I must say, you're testing even my skills here.
Please, Bigby, don't move it.
Yeah, Doc, look at my busted head.
Said it himself.
Do I have to do it? Oh, I do have to. Oh, God. Could you? Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, jeez. Oh, Lordy Lord. I'm back, Doc.
Not bad. That'll do, I suppose. He's lucky to be alive. And he won't be next time if he keeps going like this. He didn't listen to me before. Maybe he'll listen to you.
I don't know about that.
Well, he should. There are limits to what even I can do.
You know, I can't hear you.
Quiet. Just relax.
Man, we're all bloody and everything. You think he's gonna charge for the suit as well?
Perhaps it'd be better if you gave me a few minutes to finish with him.
I think I should stay. At least until he's out of the woods.
Believe me, Bigby couldn't be in better hands. And I need the space to work, so if you wouldn't mind.
I'd prefer you don't watch this anyway.
We'll be done in a moment. Just please, give us the time.
Leave already, damn it. There we go.
Hey, Doc, how much longer?
Colin, leave him be.
It's finished when it's finished.
Because I once watched a vet sew a turtle together in 10 minutes flat.
Colin, you're not even supposed to be here right now.
Oh, really? Where am I supposed to be? I'm here to take care of my friend.
Colin, shut the hell up, will you?
Yes, that would be helpful. There. All done.
Great.
This isn't a habit you should keep to, having visits with me. And, well, this time...
Jeez!
This time is no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue. Miss White, you'll be fine for light duty, if he can figure out what that means.
He knows what it means. It's just been an unusual couple of days.
Whoa, why am I double layered?
Please, don't give him the excuse. His body will eventually give out. Take care of him, please.
I will. He'll need rest, I assume.
Sleep mostly. Just keep watch and make sure he doesn't get into further altercations.
I'll try.
I can still hear you.
Anyway,
I thought everything you got to say.
Miss White, Sheriff, Colin.
Swiney.
They really hate each other.
So, how do you feel?
I feel like I got hit by a truck. Yeah, he took an axe.
See? Strong as an oak, this guy.
I'm glad you're not dead. You stopped breathing, you know, when you passed out or died, I guess. Kind of scared the hell out of me.
Yeah, gee.
Never seen you like that. And when Swineheart arrived,
I'm pretty hard to kill.
Yeah, you were really fucked up, man. You look like when you take an action figure and bend its limbs the wrong way. I'm just saying, I was worried about him, is all. The guy hasn't had a night's rest in days.
Well, I'll get some rest when this whole thing is done.
What whole thing? What's even happening out there? I mean, do you guys have like a plan or something?
No, no.
Who should I be asking? Should I be worried about the Crooked Man taking over? Or is Crane still the thing?
The Crooked Man, Bloody Mary, the Tweedles.
Tweedle at this point.
I thought it was.
Yeah. The Crooked Man came out of the shadows for a reason. For him to attack us so blatantly like that. He either feels invincible or desperate.
Well,
for what?
Two options. I don't think I'd pick desperate.
What do you mean?
You traded Crane to save Bigby. I'm just saying, that's not exactly something you do when you're playing with house money.
So he called my bluff. It's not like I'm gonna let Bloody Mary just murder
him. Yeah, about that. It wasn't your fight to surrender.
And what the hell does that mean?
It means that I was the one getting shot to shit. I'm the one that gets to raise the white flag. And only when I want to raise it. Look, Snow, I could have...
Could have done what? Gotten yourself killed? Let Crane get away anyway? It was the only option. All I care about right now is... Just what does the Crooked Man want out of this?
I
thought he was just a loan shark. But clearly, he's operating in other circles. It can't just be about Crane, right? Getting him out of town? Is this all about the murders? Crane can't be useful to him anymore. So what could this have to do with Faith and Lily?
Crane was a puppet, and the Crooked Man worked the strings. This is all about control of Fabletown.
But then what do prostitutes have to do with it? Lily? And Faith?
I don't know how it all works out yet, but I know it does. Somehow.
The Crooked Man. Declared war against us last night. At least that's what I thought.
Oh, yeah.
Now I see this war has been going on for years. We just haven't noticed it because our way of doing things is broken.
It's always been broken.
We need to do things the right way.
What does that mean, the right way?
What do you think I mean?
I don't know, but it suspiciously sounds like your way.
Yeah, wait, what do you mean? What is this?
Right way.
We haven't been doing a good job. You and I. So, starting now, we do everything cut and dried, by the book, straight as an arrow.
Yeah, aren't that straight? I'm talking about like the inertia.
Sure you're not.
This town has enough monsters. What happened last night, what you turned into, it can't happen again.
We need monsters to fight monsters.
Colin, if I really believed that we needed him to lose his flippin' mind at a moment's notice...
We were under attack, Snow. What did you expect me to do?
There are degrees.
Degrees? I only ever do what's necessary.
Really? Well, if that's the case, please explain to Colin tearing Dumb's throat out was necessary.
You can't let up until the fight is finished. He was still a threat, and that's all there is to it.
Sure.
Look, jeez.
I care about how this is done just as much as I care about it getting done.
So for that, you want to give him a handicap? Like the bad guys will worry if shit gets sloppy. Everybody wants Bigby to smile and shave and take a shower now and then. Hell, I'm practically the president of the Bigby Don't Be Such a Dick Club. But this is the wrong fucking time to put shackles on him.
Hold on. Who says I'm sloppy? I always do what I do for a reason.
And it's all turned out how you planned.
He'll get the job done. Just let him do it.
I'm going to let you do it, okay?
Man, you could close your eyes.
Now that I'm deputy mayor, I need your respect. And this situation has to end.
What situation?
All unglamored fables starting today have to go and stay at the farm.
Oh, give me a fucking break. Are you gonna let her talk to me like that?
It's been the rule for a reason, Colin. And Bigby knows it's for the best of the town. It keeps everybody out of trouble.
That's not gonna happen.
Ooh.
Yes, it will.
It's an impossible rule to enforce, Snow. You really expect to round up every talking cat and raven in town?
There's not that many stragglers left. Except the one or two you make excuses for.
It's real bloody, man.
Wolf's residence.
That's rude.
Oh, Buffkin, what is it? Okay, I'll let him know. Thanks.
Man, this is real getting dark.
He's waiting in your office right now. Narissa.
Narissa?
Who's Narissa?
From the Puddin' and Pie?
Puddin' Pie?
Apparently, she told Buffkin that she has something she needs to talk to you about. But that she'll only tell you. What do you think that could be?
Bigby's got an admirer. You always do well with the, disenfranchised.
I haven't the slightest.
Okay. I should get back to the business office. I've left Buffkin alone for too long taking calls. And I should probably change out of these clothes. Consider the discussion tabled, but not over. Let me know when you're done with Narissa.
Aye, aye, Captain. She's a piece of work.
Yeah, but she's my piece of work.
You're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you? I mean, she seemed real serious about it, but I can still hang out here.
Look, maybe a few will get sent up, but you're my friend, Colin. I wouldn't do that to you. Don't worry about it.
Thanks, Bigby.
I like the pig now. The pig has grown to me. I love the pig. Who is it now? Oh, hello, my lady.